Let's add a character onto a scene. Okay, I have a base character. It's nothing really, it's just a simple model. Not really much to see about there. So I'm going to go under my player state manager and drop the model. This will be placed at 000. I'm just going to make sure that my character or the object for the player state manager is just sits over there. Let's put for our camera a little bit, you know, in a more dynamic place. You know what I mean. Actually, I think maybe we can make this a little bit more claustrophobic. So let's go for a 30 field of view, about 30. Maybe, I don't know. That feels a little bit more survival horror-y. Okay. Maybe that's too much. Anyway, we're going to worry about that later. Let's leave it like this. So we have a model and we have a reference to our object. And now we want to move that. I'm going to go onto my state actions and I'm going to create a new script, which I'm going to call player movement. Let's open it up. And what's this? Actually, okay, player movement. Open that up. Add the namespace, delete, start an update, change this to state actions, and implement the abstract class. And for now, we can just say return false. We don't really care. We need access to the player state manager. So that means we need to cast it. This will be player states, then public player movement. It's going to be the constructor. So player state manager, player states equals player state manager. Okay, so let's do the tank controls, which are the simplest one we can do. We can actually just make a trigger for this for inside here, I guess. Let's say header input or inputs, and we can just add public bool for tank controls. Okay, inside player movement, then let's do a bool for tank controls, which is going to be returning us false or whatever we want to do over there, and a bool for camera oriented controls. And instead of return false, we can just do if player states dot tank controls return tank controls, else return camera oriented controls. Okay, so we're calling the methods we want to do. So let's start with tank controls. Tank controls are super easy, but first we do need to have a few variables. For example, how fast we are moving, how fast we rotate. So let's make this as movement or just controller stats or variables. Okay, let's do public float movement speed. That's it. Movement speed, let's say 2, or I guess 1.5 should be enough. And public float for rotation speed, let's say 2. Okay, so tank controls, as I said, they are super easy. So all we need to do is keep adding onto our rotation or into our movement based on the value we have on our horizontal and vertical. So let's see how should we do this. We can say float move amount or forward amount. Notice that I'm not using the move amount because we don't need it for this type of controls. So forward amount will be vertical multiplied by player states dot movement speed. Okay, and that will just be on M transform or player states dot M transform, which is a transform. You can say we can use translate, which is just going to be adding a vector, which in this case can be, actually let's do this as a vector forward, which is going to be player states dot M transform dot forward multiply by forward amount, and then we translate forward. We should add also the time dot delta time, and I'd rather add the time dot delta time as a float here, which I'm going to hide in the inspector. And inside my update, then I'm going to add delta time time dot delta time. So I'm going to be accessing this delta time instead of calling every time I want time dot delta time, because this is more optimized. So we can say player states dot delta time. Okay, translate can get a few more things, but for right now we can see just this. Now on our player states manager, we need to add this as an action. So we're going to add new player movement. We need to pass the player state manager, which is going to be this in this case. Let's also initialize the tank controls to start as true so that we don't have to tick it in the inspector. Let's minimize that. Okay, tank controls are ticked. I think we're going to have to raise the movement speed. So let's set this the movement speed to 100, because we are multiplying with time dot delta time. Okay, so now we're always moving forward. Let's make this 1.5, although I think it's not going to be fast enough. Okay, it's fast, it's enough. We can also walk backwards. Okay, so we have movement back and forth. Let's add rotation. Rotation is going to be very similar to movement forward, which is just going to be turn amount player states dot horizontal in this case by player states dot rotation speed. Then we can get the Euler angles from player states dot m transform dot forward Euler angles. Okay, then on the y of this we can just add the turn amount multiplied by player states dot delta time and just add it back onto your m transform. Let's see, do we have rotate? Yeah. Euler's. Let's see if that is going to work without any problems. Okay, and hit play. Okay, it's too fast. I think it's because of the rotate. Let's see. Yeah, it's probably because of the rotate. So let's do Euler angles equals Euler's. Let's try this first. Let's see. Okay. Technically, that should be a little bit better. Yeah. Okay, it rotates, but it rotates too slow. still too slow. Let's set this to 60 or whatever. Okay, depending how fast you want to move, we can do this. So here's another thing. As you can see, we keep rotating, but I'm pretty sure you're not. Oops. Okay, so the translation now is a little bit wrong. And let's see why though. I think the translate has some overload methods. Space relative to self. Let's try this first of all. Let's see what else do we have. Okay, okay, okay. I think this will be better now. Let's raise this to 50. Okay, so translate is wrong, so I'm not going to bother with it. So I'm just going to change this to position plus forward. Okay, and let's change this to 150. Let's see how this is going to behave. Yeah, okay, that's too fast. So let's say 30. 30 is too fast, of course. I guess one was enough. Okay, so now we have our tank controls are ready. But there's one small thing that we're going to cover later on a later part. For now, let's just leave it like this. So here's our tank controls. Let's do the camera oriented controls. So with our camera, it's a little bit different. We already have our player state. We already have the move direction, which means we're also going to rotate directly there. So that kind of makes our life a little bit easier, to be honest. So we're going to go over here and say target direction. We're going to start as vector3.0. If our player states dot move amount is greater than a small threshold, 0.1, for example, we can say, and we can create our, we basically just want to know if we are moving. That's the first thing that we'll have to worry about. Then we're going to say target direction will be player states dot move direction. We're going to create a target rotation from that, and we're going to do quaternion dot look rotation towards the move direction we want. Okay, then we're going to make a spherical lerp onto our transform. So we're going to say player states m transform rotation equals quaternion dot spherical lerp from player states rotation to the target rotation, and all that player states delta multiplied by player states dot rotation speed. We can of course separate and have a different variable for rotating while being oriented from the camera, or you know, moving towards the camera, and also tank controls. Okay, and the last thing we want is of course to basically just take this. We can add this via forward, so we can just get the same amount here, but instead of getting the forward amount like this, and instead of multiplying the vertical, I'm just going to multiply via the move amount. Okay, and it's going to do the exact same thing it does over here, but it's going to take into account the controls we have on both of our axes. Since this rotates us, this will move us forward. Minimize this and hit play. Okay, tank controls. As you can see, yeah, okay, let's fix that. Let's say 1.5. Okay, tank controls and so on. If we minimize the tank controls, when I'm pressing left, I'm now moving left based on the camera. Okay, this is where you should be looking. Pressing up, of course, we rotate super fast, which is not something we want, especially in case like this. It's super fast. So let's go and create a new variable inside our player state manager that is going to just say public float rotation speed camera oriented. Let's just leave this to 2, I guess. It should be that hard. And just change this. Rotation speed camera oriented. Hit play. Let's switch this to from tank controls. And there we are. We're now rotating based on the camera. Of course, feel free to play with the values and change anything you want. Okay, now on the next part, we're going to focus about something else. And as you can see, I can move. I'm not playing any animations, of course. And right now, I'm basically just floating in the air, so it doesn't matter if I'm on the ground or not. Okay, so on the next part, we're going to see what we can do about that and also play these animations. So as always, till then, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff like this, more videos, more parts for this series or any of the other series, feel free to support my Patreon so we can keep making everything we do. I'll see you next time.